Hi, good afternoon everyone. This is Chef Sunny Punjabi and today we are going to make Paneer and Fafda Subzi. So what we have over here is cottage cheese, which is simply made from Amul milk. You add lemon to it, curdle it up and then make cottage cheese out of it. There is cashew nut and couscous paste with me, onion paste, and come here. I'll just show you the spices. There is kasuri methi, bay leaf, there is cardamom, chili powder, garam masala and turmeric. And we have the fafda, that is just the main ingredient for our recipe. So let's start. Just turned off the gas. I've added some oil to it and we'll be using some herb garlic butter. So you can also use normal butter, but I'm using the Amul garlic butter since it gives a very nice flavor of garlic. There you go, the butter has started to melt down. We've added bay leaf. I just peel off the cardamom. Once your butter is melted and the cardamom leaves the fragrance, we'll add the onion paste. So this onion paste is basically, I have taken onions, I have just sauteed it in oil and I'm adding it and just pureed it. Okay, so we have the onion paste. It's a very simple recipe guys. It's hardly gonna take like 15 minutes. So onions are already cooked, I have already sauteed it before and pureed it. So I will not cook the onion much. You can add ginger garlic paste as well, but I am not doing that for now. Since I have already only used garlic butter, so I am not adding any ginger garlic paste. But it's as per your choice, you can add it. And I will add the cashew nut and couscous paste. So this is also soaked in water before puree. Once this is getting cooked, what I'll do is I'll take some more garlic butter in this. I'll just cover the gravy. So once my butter is hot, I'll add some kasuri methi to it.
and quickly I'll add some turmeric, some chili powder and a little bit of garam masala. Just giving it a stir. We'll add this to our gravy. Just add a little bit of water. So now the color has changed. We just let this cook for another like 5 minutes and should be ready on a high flame. We'll also be using some cream, Amul cream, fresh cream to give it nice richness. And what I'll be doing here with the spoon, I'll just crush it. Just give it a nice crush. We'll be adding a little bit of water to it. So now you can see the gravy has got a little thick, but just give it a nice boil. At this stage you can add the cottage cheese as well. Let it just get boiled for a minute and then we'll add the rest of the ingredients. So what fafda is going to do is, it's going to thicken up the gravy a little bit. Okay. Just taste the gravy. I need a little bit of salt. I'll add cream to it. Just check the salt again. Okay, that's perfect. Now we'll add a homemade paneer from Amul milk. Add the last and add some fafda. Just give it a mix. So the fafda will melt down and thicken up the gravy. So this will take another few minutes. So can you see that the gravy is getting thick now since the fafda is starting to melt down? Just look at the consistency. Okay, so I just give you a recap of the recipe. What we've done is we've taken a sauteed onion paste, we've added cashew nut and khaskhas paste, cooked it, we've added our spices. There is turmeric, there's kasuri methi, salt, garam masala, chili powder, there is bay leaf and there is elaichi. I've used Amul garlic butter to give it a nice flavor of garlic, and we've added fresh cream, some fafda and homemade paneer from Amul milk. So as you can see, the gravy is bubbling and getting thicker. So your dish is about to get cooked. So I have not added any chili to it because fafda has got a little bit of black pepper to it, which will give it its spice. And I think it's almost done. And it's ready to serve. So I just remove this. In a bowl. And you can just garnish it with a little bit of cream on top. There you go. That's your paneer and fafde ki sabzi.